studying that how the Polish language was the vernacular language, which was not allowed by the Russian authorities in Poland, but the priest and the church, priest and the bishops, when the church gathering took place, they preach in the Polish language. That is why these priests were sent to Siberia, and first they were imprisoned or they had given punishment, and later they were sent to Siberia. So here the language language was one of the important things which brought for the national unification, or which was one of the important factor which developed the national unification, okay, national struggle or national movement. So language and this, so we have learned about romanticism, in that we have learned three important things, that is which were they. The first thing, that German Gottfried Herder, German philosopher, he had made the importance of attachment towards the German culture, that's all. Okay, second thing we have learned about Karol Kurupinski, he conducted national struggle through the music, opera, and a lot of folk dances like polonaise and the mazurka. These all give an importance. So these all became, and the third one, the Polish language also played a very important role in the national unification. If such question is asked, you have to write about the Polish language, what I have told now about the Polish language and the Russian priest, Polish priest, or the priest and bishops in the Poland, what happened to that, that you have to write, okay? So these all created the national unification. So from this topic, we have to understand that national struggle or nation struggle was not only by the war, but many things contributed that was romanticism, and another thing that was known as romanticism, okay, cultural movement. Next, we have to study about, after this, we have to study that in 1830s, so we were learning about the 1830 to 1848, the events. So in 1830, another important problem which occurred in Europe, that was known as the Great Economic Hardship, or the Great Economic Problem, or the Great Economic Hardship, or important, very difficult condition to exist, which took place in Europe. Why it took place? Because by 1830, most of the these European societies, population increased. In many parts of Europe, population increased by 1830. When population increased, job opportunities did not increase. So people were more, but job was less. That was the condition. Now people became jobless or unemployed. Many people, they moved from villages, and they had moved towards the towns from the villages. So many people, they moved from villages to towns, and towns, in their towns, they made the slums and they started living. So by 1830, one of the another important problem which affected in Europe was very difficult condition to live, or great economic hardship. What was that hardship means? In the sense, difficult condition to live. So people had moved from, when population increased, employment conditions or employment opportunities did not increase. So that people moved from villages to towns. Okay? And due to that, but during this time, industrial revolution took place, or industries were there in Europe, especially in England, many cotton textile industries flourished. So cotton textile, cheap cotton textile or cheap textile products were reached in the market. So the many of the weavers and artisans, they cannot sell their things or sell their product, because cheap industrial goods were replaced with their product. Many people, they started purchasing the cheap industrial made goods and discarding, or they were not using the handmade things or handmade clothes. So many weavers, artisans, craft persons, everyone became unemployed. Already there is unemployment. More than that, this people also, many people became unemployed due to the industrial revolution, or industries which the things made in industries which flourished in the market, which reached to the market, and cheap products, because these all were cheap products. So people started purchasing the cheap products. That is why this created another important problem for people, that unemployment. production of food was less, food items were less, what happened? Prices automatically increased. So prices increased, which created very difficult condition for Europeans to live. This is known as one of the important event which took place in 1830 was great economic hardship. This also took place in where? In Europe, many parts of Europe. So you have learned in 9th standard about the subsistence crisis, right? Did you remember? Will you remember it? So same type of, this is one type, such type of subsistence crisis. When we read, we remember that subsistence crisis in French Revolution, okay? So same such a situation here, we can see, we could see. That means it was created, basic reason was population increase, people moved from villages to towns, slums were created, people did not get enough employment opportunities, and more than that, cheap industrial goods replaced the handmade goods, and it became, the many people became unemployed. Other than that, food production also reduced because of bad weather, food production was less, and which created increase in price of grains. These all together, it made the Europeans in poverty, pauperization or poverty, which was another problem they faced during the 1830s. So this is important points which shows the great economic hardship by 1830. Okay? And the next thing we have to study about the Silesian reverse trouble. Silesian reverse trouble or Silesian reverse revolt. There was a village in Europe known as Silesia. In Silesia, many people were weavers, handmade. They were making the handmade clothes. Okay, weavers. And these weavers, Silesia was one weaver's village, you can imagine. So in that Silesia, contractors were there to supply the raw material to the weavers. So many contractors were there. They bring the raw material to the weavers. Okay? And when they bring this raw material to the weavers, weavers had to weave it and finish the products again, is taken by the contractors and sell it in the market. So for this finished product, they used to pay. To whom? To the weavers. But what happened here that Silesia, weavers got less payment from the contractors. They get the raw material from contractors, but this raw material, when it is made into finished product, they were less paid by the contractors. Means contractors did not pay them well, how they will live, right? They had a lot of, if payment is less, they cannot live at all. So this created, they became angry, the weavers became angry or they became furious, and they started a revolt against the contractors. First they might have told that we get less payment. Contractors did not increase, they started revolt. What they did, these weavers, they went to the contractors' houses and started breaking the glass window panes, then breaking the bungalows, making huge bungalows they were living, and these bungalows they had started breaking or they started destructing the bungalows, window panes were destructed. This all happened and the contractors, they came out and they went or they fled or they ran away from that village to the next village, nearby village of Silesia. When they moved to the next village, nobody gave them any help or nobody gave them any place for them to hide. Okay? Nobody had rescued them. That is why in that village also nobody accepted. That is why they came back again. So you understood that Silesia people or weavers, they conducted the revolt against the contractors. These people or Silesian weavers, they started breaking the glasses of the contractors, breaking the bungalows of contractors. These contractors, they became helpless. They went away or they ran away from their village to the next village, nearby village. When they reached the nearby village, nobody accepted them. Okay? They came back to their village in Silesia. But here they were waiting, this revolt, revolutionaries or the weavers were waiting. So here they got the help from army, who the contractors got help. And this, they reached to the army gave help for them, and both army and contractors was also one of the important incidents during the period of 1830 to 1840. So Silesian beaver struggle, it is not a Silesian beaver struggle. This is also one of the important questions you can expect during the exam. So Silesian beaver struggle was another problem. So you can see that life was not very easy for the Europeans during the time of 1830 to 1848. Many revolt took place during this period of time. We were analyzing one by one. In that we have learned about the first upheaval took place in France, later Belgium, later Greece. Then we have learned about the Romanticism. Romanticism means many cultural factors contributed. After that we have learned about the language in the Romanticism, importance of language in Romanticism. Then we have learned about the Silesian beaver struggle, and before that we have also learned 1830 great economic hardship, another important event which took place in France, in Europe. Okay, so these all which contribute for the 1830 to 1848 revolutions. Next important revolution was in 1848, the revolution by Liberi nationalists. First they had started the revolution. Many revolution in between they had started. In 1848, revolution was started, or liberals started a revolution in 1848. This liberal revolution, which they wanted to establish a elected system and end of monarchy. This was started in 1848.